Hi, this is Jared Moss with Regional Urology. I'm one of the urologists here that specializes in male fertility. In today's video, we're going to be talking about vasectomy reversal. What is it? Who's a candidate? What are the success rates? What are my other options? And try to answer any questions that you have. Regarding vasectomy reversals, about 500,000 men every year choose to have a vasectomy, and somewhere around 4 to 6% of those men will ultimately have a change of heart and decide to pursue fertility down the road for a variety of reasons and are interested in having the vasectomy reversed. The most common question that couples ask is this my only option going forward regarding fertility with a new partner, or it still can be the previous partner if you just had a change of mind and want children later down the line? Short answer is you don't have to have a vasectomy reversal to be able to have children after you've had a vasectomy. The other option is a testicular sperm extraction and in vitro fertilization for the female. Testicular sperm extraction for a man is typically a minor procedure where we use sedation. Very small incision is made into the scrotum. We'll go into the testicle or the epididymis off to the side, and we'll get viable sperm that can then be injected into the female's eggs, hopefully developing into an embryo, which will then be transplanted into the female's uterus and hopefully result in a pregnancy and then a baby. Regarding the female side of things for in vitro fertilization, it tends to be a little bit more cumbersome for the female as opposed to the man. It involves injectable hormones, which can be quite expensive. It involves an outpatient procedure where the eggs are actually aspirated from the woman's ovaries. Those eggs are then going to be implanted with the sperm from the man that are typically taken the same day. That will then form an embryo. Those are typically incubated somewhere around 3 to 5 days, and then they'll look at the embryos and talk about transferring over quality embryos, whether it's 1, 2, 3, that will be brought over and transplanted into the woman's uterus. They'll then follow that along to see if that develops into a pregnancy and then hopefully ultimately a take-home baby. This brings us to the next, probably most important question is, what is this going to cost? Unfortunately, in the state of Louisiana and many other states, fertility is not covered under most insurance plans. And in vitro fertilization, the prices can vary greatly depending on what's needed, what's required, what state you're in, etc. I typically will tell patients it could be anywhere between $15,000 and $25,000, depending on where you live, for all-in costs for everything included. We always encourage you to please regroup with a reproductive endocrinologist if you have questions about this, to find out specifically what are their pricing policies, success rates, and things along those lines. Next, this brings us to a vasectomy reversal. We'll talk about how it's performed. It's an outpatient procedure. It's performed here at Regional Urology in our outpatient surgery center. We use general anesthesia because it requires about 2.5 hours of operative time. Again, everything is done under the microscope, so that's the reason we use general anesthesia, is we need the patient to be perfectly still for approximately 2.5 hours. Multiple tiny stitches finer than a human hair are used to perform the reconstruction. You'll go home the same day. I'll tell patients ice packs, 30 minutes on, 30 minutes off, usually for the first 24 to 36 hours. You'll typically need pain pills for at least 3 days afterwards. It is a little bit more of a difficult recovery compared to just a vasectomy. I usually tell patients maybe a week off of work at the most, and then as long as you're able to wear compressive shorts for about 6 weeks to keep everything nice and tight, as the reconstruction is obviously very delicate. There are two different types of reconstructions that can be performed for a vasectomy reversal. The first that I like to refer to is Plan A, and it's called a vasovasostomy. The patency rates, meaning putting sperm back into the ejaculate, are around 92% if a vasovasostomy is performed on at least one side. And pregnancy rates can range from anywhere from 40 to 70%. This obviously is greatly dependent on female factors, age, previous fertility, and things along those lines that can be tough to predict and give couples an exact number as far as their chance of pregnancy. The other type of reconstruction performed is what I like to refer to as Plan B, and that's a vasoepididymostomy. It's important to make sure that when you're seeing a urologist or you're being evaluated for a vasectomy reversal, that that surgeon is capable of performing a vasoepididymostomy if needed. This is a different type of reconstruction. It's typically performed in men that are a little bit further out from their time from vasectomy, anywhere from 10 to 12 years. You start to worry maybe this man is going to have a secondary obstruction. And in this instance, you take the vas deferens above where the previous vasectomy site was, and you bring it down and you perform an anastomosis to the epididymis, which is an area off to the side of the testicle where sperm mature. This is opposed to the standard, what I like to refer to, plan A, which is where you basically take the healthy vas deferens above, you bypass the area where the vasectomy was performed, and you just connect it to the lower area. It's important for patients to know that you don't know what type of reconstruction needs to be performed until you get to surgery. You can speculate based upon where the vasectomy site is located, time since vasectomy, but the truth is ultimately you don't know till you're in there. You have to sample the fluid beneath the area where the initial vasectomy was performed. If the fluid is clear, if there's sperm or sperm parts, that's going to lead you towards plan A, the vasovasostomy. If you go to the other side, for instance, and the fluid is very pasty, there's no sperm or sperm parts, that means that there's been a secondary obstruction that's developed over time. If you do the plan A, vasovasostomy, it's all going to be for naught because you're obstructed below that area. That's the instance where you have to take the vas deferens that's higher up and bring it down to the side of the testicle. The success rates if a bilateral vasoepididymostomy is performed is the patency rates are typically around 66%. The pregnancy rates can range anywhere from 30 to 50%. It's important to know if you get a vasovasostomy on one side, that's automatically going to move you up into the plan A category. Sometimes, folks, you may be researching a vasectomy reversal and looking at what your reproductive options are going forward. A lot of times we have folks that come from all areas, and we work with them to try to limit their trip to only one time they come here. So if you're 5 to 6 hours away, we're not going to ask you to make multiple trips to Shreveport to figure out if this is what you want to do. We just ask that you give us a call. My nurse, Michelle, can set up a phone conference. I'll call you, talk you through, get your history, make sure we know what's going on. If it looks like it's something that you want to pursue, we usually have you come into Shreveport once a day before. I'll need to perform a physical exam, talk through everything again, make sure there's not any questions, and then your surgery would be the following day and you'd be able to go home typically the day after. So we've talked about what a vasectomy reversal is. We know that it's not your only other option. You could also do a testicular sperm extraction for the men, in vitro fertilization for the woman. Generally speaking, your success rates are going to be pretty comparable for both approaches. So we always encourage patients, meet with a reproductive endocrinologist, meet with your urologist, and then ultimately you'll find out what's going to be the best procedure for you. We talked about how it's performed. Here at Regional Urology, we do it at our outpatient surgery center. Typically takes about 2.5 hours. General anesthesia is performed, and it's all done with a microsurgical approach. We talked about the post-operative recovery. Our folks that are coming in from out of town, we talked about our success rates, the different types of reconstructions that can be performed. So I hope that you'll find this helpful. If you have any questions or concerns, please let us know. All of this will be listed on our website, regionalurology.com. It's under the patient education tab, and then male fertility, and you can go to the vasectomy reversal area. We have areas on the website where you can request more information. Our telephone number is 318-683-0411. Michelle is my nurse slash boss, is what I like to refer to her as, but her extension is 136. If you have questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. We're happy to talk to you and try to help you make the right decision. Thanks.